We're going to use calculus to relate the volume of a cylinder with its changing radius. The volume is given by the square of this radius times pi times the height of the cylinder. And we want to find the rate of variation of volume with the radius when the radius is 5.5 units and the height is 20 units. So what are we looking for? The variation of the volume, that is dV. And the rate that it changes with the radius, that is dV by dr. So that is what we're after. In this case, it's the radius that we're tweaking and the height is staying constant. We treat pi and h as constants and we differentiate with respect to r. And we end up with 2 pi times r times h. And now we plug in our values for r and h and we get a number for dv by dr. And the number we get is 690.8. Well, what does that mean? It means that if we change the radius of this cylinder by 1 unit, the volume will change by 690.8 units. Here's another question that we can ask. We can say, okay, what if we start from a place where the height and the radius are the same? Let's find the dimensions of the cylinder where a 1 unit change in radius will result in a change in volume of 400 units. Again, we've already worked out how the volume changes with the radius. That's dV by dr. We had 2 pi r times h. But at this instant, r and h are the same. So we can rewrite this as 2 pi r squared. This time, we've got dV by dr. And we're looking for r. So we want to rewrite this equation in terms of r. Then once we've done that, we plug in the values that we know. The 400 for dV by dr, 2 pi is always a constant, and now we're going to take the square root of that, and we end up with about 7.98. Bob is your uncle, and this can of soup is over 20 years old. So if I ever open it, I'll make sure that I show it on YouTube before I collapse. Meanwhile, check out this other stuff and cheers.